Well, here we are again in one person's descent into fine scale madness. Not a bad day's work. We've got preliminary bench work in place. It's one of the support columns hogging the photo there. Basic L girder construction. Nothing novel, nothing innovative. It's a fairly lightweight L girder. I've seen American layouts built with framework that you could walk on. Astonishing. Funnily enough, my father was a fairly good home carpenter, but I have none of his skill. So my carpentry is not the best. And I can't guarantee that this is perfectly square. I cannot guarantee that this is perfectly level. But it will keep trains up off the floor, and that's the main thing. And no one's going to be walking on it. It's actually lightweight enough that I can lift that whole section out of the way on my own, which is handy to get round the back and do put the back scene on and things like that. We've done a bit of preparation on the walls. You can see filling in some of the larger holes, because this is a very poorly constructed garage. Filling in the larger holes with polyurethane foam to keep out moisture and draft and insects too, critters, because Australia's got more bug uglies than you can point a stick at. It's got like these massive spiders and things, and they'll come in and out of all these bloody holes, so it's best to seal it up and try and keep the vermin infestation down in some ways. So toying about whether I will seal the walls with a bitumen type product just to keep down moisture may be a good idea. This is the dry end of the garage, and it's a very dry country, so we're not expecting rain in the near future. I think I've just lost my light. So it must still be a wise investment to do that. And so that's the basic framework for the layout. The main part, there's the light again. Main part of the layout, as you see, is I've got the front stays still to put on. The back stays are in place. Only construction has finished for the day because I've actually run out of wood screws and the shops are all shut. But that will be the bulk part of the layout, which is just a figure eight with a return loop, or sorry, an oval with a return loop. Nothing imaginative. This section round to the left, where these boxes and things are, that will be the terminus, up to about here, about the end of those boxes. It'll be the stub end terminal that will then feed trains onto that part of the layout. So I'm quite pleased. I got through all that I had intended to do today, which is always pleasing. I must admit, these things here, I bought a pair of these today. These are my new best friend. These are my new favorite thing in the world, because I work on my own, and you never have enough hands. And my daughter is still much too small and too young for come here and hold this for daddy. So these things have been brilliant, and they've really speed up construction because I've been able to just one hand clamp things in place, then drill and screw and get on with it. So all in all, I am quite pleased with today's efforts. They'll put the front stays on the legs tomorrow after a trip to the hardware store. And nothing feels better when you're building a model out to make some progress. To be at the end of the day seeing like, well, bench works up and you feel like you're getting somewhere. Because otherwise it gets tedious and drags on, and then you start to lose interest. Or life has a habit of getting in the way, you know, with work and family and chores and things. So it's always good to make a good start. So I'm quite happy with today's progress. And we'll update again soon, when there's something a little bit more substantial to look at. Thanks for watching.